Hello, my name is Asad Farooqi and I'm from Pakistan, and I would like to show you now a machine which I made in my country. And that machine can turn waste plastic, waste garbage plastic into oil. So I would like to just brief you a little bit. So we all know that we are the waste plastic generated is more than its recycling, how to recycle it. So we are trying to find the solutions for recycling and getting rid of waste plastics are less, so the garbage is increasing day by day. So we have tried to find a good solution to put the waste plastic back into its original form, and that is oil. So waste plastics like this, you can see in this, these are the shopping bags. These all can be put in a machine like this, and this machine can turn this waste plastics into oil. So the best thing is that it converts, produces about 90% oil, and only 5% this carbon ash is left from it. So if you bring a full truckload of this waste garbage from the one truckload, you might only end up into 100 kg of this carbon ash, and all the waste trash, the full truckload is gone, is recovered, and we recover a precious thing, that is oil. And this is not an ordinary oil. This oil is a mixed fraction, and from that we can produce diesel oil, we can produce kerosene oil, and we can produce naphtha. So that's what we have tried to done. And now I would like to take you to our demonstration unit. It's placed here at Highgate Engineering University in Switzerland, and Institute d'Hygiène Thermique Systèmes Industriel de Bioénergie. Sorry, my French is zero, but that's what I can do. So this is where the machine is now. And now I'll take you to the machine and show you and brief you a little bit about that. So this machine is placed in a container. So the best thing is, even the bigger plants we are making are all containerized plants. So it's easy for everyone to take the container and take it anywhere. Just plug the utilities like water, electricity, and start running the plant. It's like a plug and play, all compact, built in a container. So that's the basic idea. So now I walk through. This is a demo machine in which about 40 to 50 kilos of waste plastics can be put in one time, and we can pyrolyze it, convert it into oil. First, I would like to explain you what pyrolysis is. Pyrolysis is a technology in which we heat the plastic to a temperature where it starts to crack and into its vaporized form, and that temperature is 400 degrees Celsius. But the main thing is that if we heat the temperature to such temperature, and if oxygen from the air is mixed in it, it's gonna catch fire, and it will be a big blow. So the trick is to burn the plastic and in a closed environment without oxygen. So this pyrolysis is called in basic words. So this is our main reactor in which we feed the material from this particular part, we close it. This is a demonstration machine in which we can only run a batch type machine. We have to first put the material in it and then close it. The new machines, the bigger commercial plants we are making, that's a continuous feeding machine. You continuously feed the material from one part, and it is going inside. There are special arrangements for it that no oxygen is going in there. So there are special laws, it's a special system for that. So just for a demonstration purpose, this is a simple machine which I'd like to show. So here the material is heated, and this is the furnace. This furnace is heated by a burner. This is a gas burner. And one important thing is that the gas used first to heat up the plant, when the pyrolysis process starts, it does not only produce oil, but it also produces gas. And this gas is a mixture of methane and LPG. So this mixture, we again bring it back through this orange pipe and supply to the burner. So the idea is that it is a self-sufficient plant, and this self-sufficient plant is running on its own gas. You don't have to feed gas or to run this plant. So So this is the basic idea. So here we start, this is the burner, starting point. We start this process first with an LPG gas to start the reaction. So to start the reaction, we are first feeding with LPG. So once the pyrolysis is on, it's producing its own gas. So then we cut off the LPG gas and it's running on its own gas. So this is the first part. So here is the burner, in the furnace, and here is the big fire. From here only the hot gases are traveling in to the reactor. This is a double walled reactor. This double walled reactor has spirals in it, so the hot air is passing through the reactor, making it heat, hot, and then going out. So now the temperature will go up as soon as it reaches around 380 degrees Celsius. The plastic will crack and convert into vapors. So these vapors are then transferred from here to this reflux tower, and this reflux tower makes sure that the plastic liquid particles don't boil over, jump out of the reactor. So if some particles are jumping out of the reactor, this reflux makes sure that they are gone back, so it could be cracked 100%. So only the vapors are passed through this reflux tower into the catalyst tower. So this is the catalyst tower. Here we put special catalyst. Frankly speaking, when we pyrolyze plastics, especially the shopping bags, polyethylene, it does not produce oil. The reason is the chemistry of polyethylene is that it produces wax-like particles. So at the end of the day, when you pyrolyze it, you get wax. Then you have to put it, process it again. So the best thing would be, we have developed certain special catalyst which you put in this, and the vapors of plastic, when passed through this catalyst chamber, they react with the catalyst. Some ion exchange is taking place. There are special zeolites, and through this iron exchange, the long chains of the wax particles are cut into short and oil particles are produced. So that's what this catalyst chamber is doing. So now here, from the catalyst chamber, the vapors pass through it, through the iron chambers. It is like a honeycomb. If you see a honeycomb or a sponge, so the wax particles, which are bigger particles, are passing through it. The ion exchange is taking place and making sure the big particles are cut into small particles from C9 to C21. So this is the diesel range particle process. So now after passing through this catalyst tower, the vapors then go to the three condensers. These are three oil condensers. I have put these three oil condensers deliberately to make sure that vapors are condensed partly, not in one time, in three times. First, in this condenser, the heavy particles, which we call the diesel range oil, are condensed. Then came the medium range heat exchanger, which condenses particles around kerosene range. And this is the naphtha or the light range particles coming in, or the gasoline particles coming, are condensing in this condenser. All the oil which is condensed is drained into these tanks. This is for the gasoline one, and this is for the diesel one. One important thing is that, as I told you before, that this process not only produces oil, it also produces gas. So that gas has some sulfur properties, it is and other things. So we neutralize the gas. So for that, this yellow tank we have installed, it has some chemicals in it which treat the gas, neutralize the gas, so this gas could be used for burning of anything else. So this is a small bubbler. You can see some bubbles coming out like this. So this bubble gives us a very good idea when the reaction is start. So as soon as the reaction is up, the pyrolysis is up, it starts to bubble a lot. So when it bubbles a lot, this means this is the indicator that the pyrolysis is going on, and after oil has been condensed, only the gases are coming out. So this is a very simple and a very effective way of seeing what the process is going through. So as soon as the pyrolysis is done, this when the pyrolysis is on, it makes lot of bubbles, and as soon as the pyrolysis is done, these bubbles start to die down, which gives an indicator, okay, now the process is up, so we can stop the machine and do something else. So here one more thing I would like to explain. Okay, so these bubbles coming out from here, they pass through it, they get a chemical treatment from it, and from here you can see the orange pipe. So this is the orange pipe,
right,
which is going, carrying the syngas, we call it, the syngas, to a yellow tank which is down there. So I'll ask, please come from here. This is the yellow tank. This is, we call, the gas header tank, in which the LPG gas is mixed. LPG gas is also coming, and the syn gas is also coming. As soon as the pyrolysis is done, started, we make our the plant makes its own gas. So that's the time then we start to cut off the LPG, and only our gas is being transferred to this tank, and from there it's supplied to the burner. So this is the gas header tank, we call it. So we'll take a pause and I'll take you outside and show you how this header tank is. Okay, take a pause. Okay, so this is the header tank. So as you can see, these are the orange pipe coming here, and this is feeding, this LPG gas is feeding in it. And this is the yellow one, the pipe coming out of the plant, the process, this pipe is coming in, the gas from the pyrolysis is being feeding in this, through this pipe into this reactor. So now we have two gases coming in. So these are the regulators which are supplying the gas to the burner. So we have set the pressure, what pressure is required, and how much gas is required. So as soon as we have sufficient gas produced in our system, we just shut off the LPG, and this tank is supplying only the syn gas produced by this plant to the burner. Okay. So this is a concept here, and this is the oil condensers. The heat exchangers are water circulated, water cooled. So this is the water tank supplying water, pumping water in the tank. So this is a basic pyrolysis unit. And now we take another pause and go back and show you one more thing. Jin, excuse me. There is some. Okay, so this is okay, there are two things more which I'd like to show. This is not just an ordinary reactor. We've got a stirrer placed in the reactor. The reason we're placing a stirrer in a reactor, plastics are bad conductors of heat and electricity. We all know that. So to take the temperature up to the plastics, so we have placed a stirrer. This stirrer is moving in a direction, so making it sure that the heat is evenly transferred to the material. So this is one part of the stirrer is going on. But we are also doing taking another work from the stirrer. As soon as we see that the pyrolysis is done, the plastic has been pyrolyzed. Now the carbon ash, the black ash, is sitting in the reactor. We have to take it out for the next process. So as soon as we see the pyrolysis is over, then what we do, we again use the stirrer to take the carbon ash out of this reactor. And from this reactor is good in this ash tank. It's a carbon ash tank. So
So it is linked with this reactor, as you can see. So there is a simple mechanism for that. So as soon as the reactor is over, this carbon ash tank is operated, and all the ash is thrown inside the carbon ash tank, and then the system is closed. So now immediately you can put more plastic in it and use it. This is a basic machine, it's a batch type, but the continuous one, you can run the machine for 10 hours, 20 hours. As soon as you are done, you open it, put all your carbon ash in the tank and start feeding new material. In batch type machines, normally you have to open it every time and take out the carbon ash manually. That's a very laborious job and it's dangerous. Because if it is having some pressure in it, it can cause problems. So this is a continuous process. You need not to open anything. It's closed and done.
Where do you put the plastic in?
We put the plastic in from that particular point. You can see the flames there.
Yeah.
So that's the point we put the plastic in. Yeah. You can go from here. Now I would like to show you one more important thing, that is fuel treatment system. Normally all the plants produce oil which is dark in color and have not a good smell. So we have developed a special fuel treatment system. We have placed some chemicals in it and we pump, as soon as the oil is ready, we pass the oil through this oil pump into this machine, into this cylinder where the chemicals are. So those chemicals makes the color of the oil from dark brown to golden yellow. It converts, changes the color, take out the sulfur fractions. So it's doing a very good job. And after that, this is a filtration system. So this is a fine mesh filter. So we have to make sure that the oil coming out has no gum particles, no foreign particles, no dirt particles. Because if your oil is containing these particles, then it will mess up in the engine. Especially it will damage the injectors and other engine parts. So which is, in any case, unacceptable. So this is the fuel treatment system with filtration which I have developed. So it's also installed in the same pit. So everything is done. Everything is processed in the same one kit. So this is a brief review of this machine. I hope you like it.
And also the smell. It also removes the smell.
Yeah, it also decreases the smell of the oil very well. So in the next part, we will show you the oil, how it's made, and after this fuel treatment, what the color we can get. So that will be coming next. Thank you very much. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day. Goodbye.
Hi. When I first built this machine, I built it with just all manual start, stop buttons, push buttons, and all the temperature coming here, showing it. So it was a manually operated machine. But now in Switzerland, we converted this machine into a fully automated working machine with a PLC control. Now I'm going to show you our PLC control system. So this is our fully automated system. And with thanks from Alps Automation, this company is a big automation company of Switzerland, and they are doing all the automation work for companies like Nestle. So Nestle is one of their clients, Syngenta. So it's an internationally renowned company and making all automation panels for their whole plants all around the world. So they are supplying 40 countries. So they were kind enough to help us in developing the automatic system. In this automatic system, everything is PLC controlled. We have to just, through this panel, set all the parameters. So now, as you can see, please zoom in. The temperature of the reactor is 254 degrees Celsius. So as soon as the temperature goes to 380 degrees Celsius or 400 degrees Celsius, when the pyrolysis start, so automatically it will start the water circulation system and take care of that. And when the gas is produced, it's producing its own gas, it can shut off the LPG gas, and this gas is used. So these are some automating things. so which is already done by itself. It also controls the burner also, because we have a set point. The pyrolysis starts at 380 degrees Celsius up to 450 degrees Celsius. So at 450, it shut down the burner and let the temperature fall down to 400 degrees Celsius. For 400 degrees Celsius, again the burner starts by itself. The PLC takes care of it and takes the temperature 450 degrees Celsius. So it's going up and down. And one more thing, this had a black box, a data. So all the work which is going on is being recorded. So we can get a printout of the whole process, at what time the temperature were. And it is not only recording the temperature of this reactor or the catalyst tower, the all heat exchanger, what the temperature of all heat exchangers are, DC1, 2, 3, what are the temperature, at what time. So these are all things, parameters, which are shown, not only displayed here, but also recorded. And we are also making Excel sheet, developing Excel sheet, so we can get a full printout. We run a batch for 1 day, so at what time, what set parameters are. So this is something, a next step, and which was required, and we did it here. And along with this, because I'm coming from a country, Pakistan, where the safety standards are quite on the lower side. And when I came to Switzerland, they say, no, our safety standards has to be followed, only then we can touch this machine or start this machine. So here, in the college, they added all these safety instruments. So one is a fire alarm, this is a gas alarm, and they have put special this is carbon monoxide detector. So if carbon monoxide or any gas is detected, then the fire alarm will go on and it will shut down the system. And this is the first one. And the second one, this is the hydro carbon detector. So this hydrocarbon detects if there's any hydrocarbon fumes or vapors coming in this container. Again, the alarm will go on and it will shut down the system. So this is all automated with this panel, and these safety devices are installed in it. So this is one thing which I learned here in Switzerland, working in this research institute. So it was a good experience, a good learning experience for me. And because of it, now we are designing a big commercial plant, which is a continuous one, of whom I'll give you the details later on.
Estimated yield 80%.
Yeah. Wow. In Brazil, we are getting up to 80 to 90%. The mixed plastics, we have got polystyrene, PP in it, up to 90%. From 100 kg, from 1 ton of plastic, we are getting 900 to 950 liters of oil from it.
And so I was explaining here, the oil is all left here, the right. Gas goes here. Mm-hmm. This is a special oil gas treatment, chamber, yeah. Where the gas is treated, sulfur is removed, the gas is neutralized. Okay. So it is good, then sent to a storage tank. Right. From this storage tank,
it goes back to the burner.
Okay. But it's not here. The gas produced by the system, yeah. Only 50% of gas is consumed by the burner. So the next 50% of the gas, you put it on a flare. In my country, I plug it in a genset,
yes.
And run the generator.
Of course.
So this plant can run a generator of 100 kilowatts.
Okay.
Plus this burner. This gas is free.
Mm-hmm.
Produced by it.
Yeah.
It's on top of it. On top of the oil.
On top of this 80%.
It's normal, 80% is nothing. 80% is nothing. We go up to 90%.
So, the thing is, plastic consume 130 to 100,000 liters.
Mm-hmm.
In Brazil case, we are selling diesel, pyrolysis diesel at price of 60 to 70 cents a liter. This is our cost, this is our saving per month. With this saving, $300 $1,000 plant, mm-hmm. The payback period is 1 year.
Mm-hmm.
1 year, we get our payment back.
You have a business card?
Yes. And I would like to have one of them.
Definitely, you will have my picture.
He's a businessman, you know.
So You got a smiling picture. That's a good one.
This is my uncle.
No, you are looking. This one is 5 years younger.
Yes. I was taken 10 years ago.
I pray that you again get 10 years younger.
10 years
and
younger.
I've got a formula for that.
They need to work a lot. Stay young.
No, I have become 5 years younger. Instead of going old, I'm getting younger.
Huh?
I used to do yoga.
Yes.
And now I'm teaching yoga.
Okay.
And what I feel that I feel 10 years younger than what I was doing before yoga.
Uh-huh. Okay.
So that's really I love, and now I'm teaching to other people.
But you are Pakistani,
yes,
or you're Indian?
Pakistan.
Don't confuse, please.
It's a big difference now. We are always fighting Indian and Pakistanis.
Yes, there is a war all the time.
Always. We are always fighting.
Your card, sure. Please.
Sure.
Okay.
So this is a good name. I've heard it.
Yes.
And seen a nice video with a duck floating.
Yes.
Oh, is that that video that shared with me? That's him.
Ah. This is us.
Okay.
But so welcome to the club.
yes.
And the difference is we don't do pyrolysis. We do thermalization.
What I understand yeah. In your plant, first there's yeah. one reactor, the plastic is melting, then it sends the second reactor where it's spiralizing.
No, this is just to show people how it should be, but it is not the truth. Because the truth is completely different. We stay in one reactor.
Sir, I saw this video 10 times.
Yes,
and 10 times I was believing, you are doing pyrolysis.
Yes.
But we made the video so people think we make pyrolysis.
Okay. Yeah, I also saw the color, the oil coming out, and you're sending a full 10,000 liter truck going to a building or apartment building and giving that to the burner.
You've seen the video.
10 times. 10 times. I'm still in the...
Okay. Today, our technology is not finished. It's not industrialized. We can transform 50 to 250 liters per hour. And the target is 500 liters per hour with 5 reactor per plant. And we will treat 60 tons of plastic per day because it is an industrial...
Yeah. So you'll be targeting about 10 tons per day per plant. 10 into 60.